Hey everybody, what's up? Welcome back to the Gamescage. Today and only today, I thought I would try a new setup. Maybe like this has like a better flair to it. Let me know actually if you prefer like the more professional in my room sitting where I've got like the rotating chair, or if you like this kind of more casual setting where I'm on the couch, got my poster in the background, it's gonna be lit. Maybe I'll experiment more. I need your feedback, so please let me know. So anyways, hey everybody, what's up? Welcome back to the Gamescage. Today and only today, we're gonna be discussing Terry Bogard slash Challenger Pack 4 in general. I thought I would do like a little review of it, tell you my thoughts on it, what I think of Terry, the stage, the music, everything about this pack and why it's worth it or if it's not worth it. But I can already definitively tell you this pack is so worth it. So obviously, unless you've been living under a rock, Challenger Pack 4 for Super Smash Bros. Ultimate is Terry Bogard. And Terry Bogard is a big character from King of Fighters slash Fatal Fury and old school Neo Geo series. And obviously, Sakurai gets into deep detail about that. I mean, obviously, if you're watching a review for a Terry Bogard character in Smash, you probably already know, you've seen the presentation, you've seen the memes and everything. But what I'm here to tell you is, as a Challenger pack, I think Terry's pack might be one of my favorites. I think in general, Terry might be one of my favorite characters in Smash already. I think his pack is awesome, and we're gonna get into each part like individually. So first of all, obviously the star of the show, the character Terry. The way I can describe him is he's kind of what I've always wanted Ryu to be like, because Ryu in fighting games is usually always my primary character. Like, he's the character I will always pick, and like, I mean, I'll pick obviously stuff like Kami or some others, but like, usually my main in Street Fighter is Ryu. I just understand him, I like him, I know he's simple, but whatever, it gets me going, alright? So, but whenever I played him in Smash, it's like, for a character I love so much to not feel that great in Smash, I could never get into him, which bothered me, right? It's like, and I think it's because he's got his original command input moves, but like, you have to do them, like, you also have those attacks where you press A at a right moment for it to do a different style move, so it was a little too complicated for me to like enjoy. Whereas Terry, I think, is the perfect mix of, hey, you can do original inputs from his old school games to do bigger damage, but it never feels like it's too complicated. Like, once you learn the five command inputs, which you've got like your regular attacks, you've got your power gazer, your little flip kick, you've got your Busta Wolf punch, and then when you go over 100%, you get this go meter, right? This go meter basically unlocks you two super special moves, which is like obviously a very fighting game thing. You can use a move called power gazer, which is like this giant explosion you can smash out, or you can use this move called is it just Busta Wolf but like super powered, right? I think it's like, what is it, super Busta? I don't fucking know. One of those two. He just yells, "Are you okay?" and then grabs you and fucking kills you. Like, why would you ask if someone's okay when you just fucking yeeted them out of the earth? But either way, he's just, his moveset is so fun and satisfying. The way I say it is like I say, he's a mechanically better Ryu. He's just so fun to play. And what I like about it is, like, I've had friends playing him that aren't good with original inputs, because you can just do the side B, his up B, his down B, his regular specials, and you're still gonna have a good time. He's just a really fun character, and beyond just fun, he's flashy, right? And he's also got another, like, he's got a couple unique mechanics of, he's got a back special, which is something not many characters at all have, I think. So he's the first character to have a back special, which I think should be explored more, actually, because like that adds like a fifth special. It's obviously a little harder to execute, but it's a really unique idea, and basically he does this like he flings himself forward with a backward kick, and it's just, he's just super stylish, he's super fun, his taunts are really cool, he's just like, hey, come on, come on, and he's just like, he's doing his thing, living his life. It's like, he's just such a fun character, like, he's very expressive too, and I think, obviously, Sakurai did an amazing job in the direct of being like, why should you care about this character? Because I genuinely feel like I care about this character. I've only played two King of Fighters games. I played King of Fighters 98 and I played King of Fighters 14. So it's like, I knew who Terry was, but I just didn't care about him. And now, thanks to Smash, I care about him. He's just such a fun, expressive character, and he's just really cool. Now, when we go into the stage, I love the stage. The King of Fighters Stadium is so cool, not just because it's a cool stage, but because of two reasons. One, it's got a unique mechanic of basically, when you're trying to hit someone onto a wall, like when you're trying to obviously smash someone out, which Smash is known for, the walls are blocked and you gotta hit them out with a certain amount of damage to break the wall and kill your opponent. So really cool mechanic with that stage, and it's also a beautiful stage. Like, I've always really liked flat stages, like with no like falling areas. Like, I don't mind falling areas, but I don't know, there's something about the flat stages I really love. Like, I think Colosseum is like my favorite Smash stage, which is really weird, but it's like, the stage is so well done, and obviously, like, you've got the cameos in the background. No May, no big titty ladies. No, how can we have no big titty ladies in Smash, bro? Anyways, that's not the point here. But either way, stage is just so cool. You can tell it was made with love and care. I don't know why it looks like a football field. Like, when you look in the background, it's a fucking football field. Really weird, but really cool. And even the Omega and Battlefield versions of the stage are really cool. Like, it's got a unique layout and look to it. So, stage is really fucking cool. One of my favorites. Music. Obviously, I don't have to tell you how fucking dope the music is. Sakurai came through with the On God moment, and he basically got over 50 songs to show the fuck up here. And it's like, it is insane just how many songs there. I haven't even heard them all. I don't think so. But it's like, you've got Metal Slug music, you got King of Fighters music, you got Fatal Fury music, you've got fucking Samurai Showdown music. It's just all SNK music, and it's just so fucking good. It's so well made, it's so well done, and obviously the spirits are really fun. I only did like a two of them, but they're fun. Again, you get another classic mode, which is a really unique one where you fight three characters every round, which is obviously a reference, but it's like, it is just such a well-crafted DLC pack as a whole. I think it's obviously the most content pack. Like, you're getting a very complex character, you're getting an amazing stage, you're getting 50 songs. The thing about this DLC pack is, even if you don't like Terry, it's worth it for the 50 SNK songs alone. Like, and the stage. It's like, if for some reason, I get if Terry's not your jam, it's just worth it for those songs. It's like $6. It's ridiculous how fucking cheap these things are. It's like an unbelievable amount of work from Sakurai and the team. And I just really think this might be my favorite DLC pack. Again, whether it's not my preferred character. But to be fair, he might become a character I really adore, because I already love him so much. I put like 6 to 7 hours just playing him, and it's like, he's just really special. He's really dope, and I just love him, and I love the pack, and I think they did an amazing job with this one. It's like, it's awesome. And obviously, you probably have this, so I'm just giving my thoughts out there. But if you don't, I recommend you give it a shot, because even if you don't think you're gonna like Terry, like I said, it's worth trying him, because he's fun, easier to get into than you think. And once you learn those command inputs, on God, bro, on fucking God. So yeah, I just fucking love him so much, and I hope y'all love it too. So anyways, that's my mini review of Challenger Pack 4, Why Did I Lose My Voice Here, and I'll see y'all next time. Peace. I love you.